everyone. Mary here from Ireland. I've got a Facebook page called Mary from Ireland. I've got a Facebook page called Angels Love and Light. And my website is angeliclifeguidance.com. And I'm available for readings, mentorship, counseling, spiritual, whatever you want. Check it out on my website. In Ireland, online, by email, video, audio, phone, Skype. So check that out. What a week. I was looking back on my October reading, which I did on the 26th of September. And it couldn't be more spot on in my life. It talked about the solar plexus. It spoke about reaching out, listening, and I mean, so far we're only what, 11 days, 12 days into October, and it's all come to pass with me. I've had such a week, no idea what was going on, of course, until it was over. And powerful stuff is all I can say. I would say, I know we're all energy healers, our energy is being extended out onto the planet, but with me and with many others, people would say you're empaths, but to me, I'm being taught about energy, and it comes through my body. I don't do Reiki, I don't do craniosacral, I receive all those things, but the energy comes through my body to teach me, and next thing I feel it in whatever part of my body, and I just work my way through it then. What does it feel like? What does it remind me of? What am I healing? Is it collective? Is it my own? Is it family? So just powerful stuff, absolutely powerful stuff, and I'm good. And I must say, Abraham Hicks' guidance, The Path of Least Resistance, helped big time. And the path of least resistance for me during the week was get into bed, snuggle up. You don't have to eat big feeds or anything like that. Just get up, have something light. And I sat and I thought and I felt, what is the path of least resistance? Into bed again. And you see, it's very, very hard for me to do that because I feel I need to be doing all the time. So I remember a story about my grandfather, and if he was running out of cigarettes and he knew he wouldn't have enough for the next day, he would leave the work he was doing and get into bed. So I spoke to him until, like, it's the path, it's momentum. It's the very same as Abraham Hicks says, break the momentum and get up the next day in different form. So it took me 2 days now, I must say, but it taught me about letting go, and it taught me about giving myself permission to do nothing. It was great, but I did work through all I had to work through as well, and I discovered what it was all about and when, and there were so many synchronicities with friends, and they were doing things in different ways, but we were all being catapulted back to a certain time in our lives, in the 1980s and the 1990s. So very interesting. So this week what I'm doing is using Doreen Virtue's Goddess Guidance Deck, give us a little bit of goddess power. And then I'm going to choose one at the end from my new deck, Postcards from Spirit by Colette Baron Reid. And they're beautiful, I'll show them to you. So we'll choose, I think, one goddess card at a time, and I'll know when to stop. Like, I'm thinking three or four. Oh, brilliant. Abundantia, prosperity. The universe is pouring its abundance out to you. Be open to receiving. Okay? And that's just be open to receiving. Work on your feminine side. Receive. You are well well deserving of all the goodness that's coming to you. Receive it. You don't have to be doing and giving all the time. Be open to receiving. Okay? And let yourself off those hooks that you have yourself on. You don't have to be minding everybody. You don't have to be doing for everybody all the time. You don't have to be rescuing anybody. They're well able to walk their own path. You don't have to be spreading your energy around all the time. Look after you. Okay? You. Sit and feel, what do I really want to do at this minute? Do I want to go for a walk? Do I want to set up a group? Do I want to join a voluntary group? I had all those suggestions from people during the week. And I went, no, I can't. I haven't the energy to do anything. So the path of least resistance was just get out of there. Cut off from the world and relax and sleep or rest or whatever. So whatever your path of least resistance is this week, go for it. What feels best for you? And as your energy is calm and at peace, you're going to receive. Okay? Maybe I just should stop at one. Endings and beginnings. We had this last week. Callie. I love, love, love that card. Third eye opening. Watch your nighttime dreams. Close your eyes and dream your dreams and see what visions come to you. Follow the moon's energy. I don't know where we are with the moon. We had a full moon. Follow the planets. Jupiter has gone into Scorpio, which is a big deal seemingly. And we had the 10-10 portal, which was a big deal too. And all my stuff kicked off. Well, it started Monday, which was the 9th of the 10th, or 10-9 in America, and 10-10, it really escalated. And I was given out to the universe. So what's going on here? 10-10 is supposed to be a good day. But I had to feel whatever I was feeling. It was an intense day, got through it, and now on the good side of it. So endings and beginnings. The old must be released so that the new can enter. Okay, so if it makes sense to any of you, the 1980s and the 1990s, what was going on for you, and what the Leo King is saying is 2005, 2006, but he's also saying 2012. So any of those dates, anything that's coming up for you around any of those years, have a look. See, are you clearing anything from them? So we'll go one more. Oh, yes. Diana. Focused attention. Keep your eye on the prize. I don't know how many times I've been told that. So focus. Keep your unwavering thoughts, feelings and actions focused on your target and you will make your mark. Like I was asked during the week, what are your dreams? Focus on your dreams. And I got to a stage where, no, I have no dreams. I don't know anymore. Everything has changed. I'm in a new. I have no idea where I'm heading. But I have a few of them back now. And focus your attention. Make your decisions. Where am I heading if you're at a crossroads? What do I want to point my arrow at? And go for it. Ask Spirit what my next step is. What do I have to do or clear or not do next? Lovely, lovely. So here are the postcards with a stamp on them. Very cool. And I have typing, I'll show you, typing on them. Now there's a bundle of them gone. Like an old typewriter, is what I would say. Now this is going to be our journey back to love reading for this week. I'm going to do, straight after this, I'm going to do a soulmate divine partnership reading for Patreon patrons. Okay, if you want to pop over there, pledge $1 to $1,000, whatever you can afford. It's just a token, and I give some extra readings there. My God, they're all falling out. So we'll go here. Now, what's jumping at me? I think two, a blue one and something else. So we'll do the blue one. And you see, we have this, and it is very hard to read this. It's in joined writing. So there is a reindeer, so Christmas. You are beauty, I think. We'll read it. So here is the card, and you see the typing on it. It looks an old typewriter. Dearest you, the common sayings, be in the world, but not of it, and wear the world loosely, refer to the need to be engaged with life while not being attached to specific outcomes. I've said that in my Soulmate Divine Partnership last week, and most definitely, don't be attached to outcomes. Just feel your feelings, focus your attention on what you'd like to happen and what your dreams are, but don't be disappointed if the outcome doesn't come as you expect it to. Feel the love. Do not take this world too personally, for you are one of many co-creators here to play. And we have many ideas about how all this should play out. Just know the outcomes don't matter as much as the presence you bring to each experience and how you let yourself flow through life. There's a real freedom in knowing and accepting this. So will you wear the world loosely or will it straitjacket you? It is your choice. Whatever happens, have the courage to keep trying to live as you're meant to. And when it comes to manifesting, don't worry about the how. And I'm one of those, like, when and how this manifestation, because it's taken so long and it's going around the scenic route and I've no idea how. No idea how, so I've let go of the how. And when it comes to manifesting, don't worry about the how or even the why. We have that covered. Everything is going to turn out exactly as it should. Spirit has a plan. Loving you always and forever. So that's it. Don't worry. Let go of the worry. There's a plan. Be fearless. I don't know what she's doing there. Dearest you, sometimes it's wonderful to give, but there are times you might find yourself overgiving. Now, this was going on for me last week too. Now might be a good time to check in and see where you might be cutting off the flow of abundance. Let others give to you, even if you are more comfortable being generous and being the giver, the healer and the rescuer. I have been healing since 2009, and during the week I said, could you please bring somebody else in to either take this from me or give me a hand with it? So that's what this is all about. Giving too much of yourself burns you out. And you're not learning to receive. And that was our first message. Receive. Being generous and being the giver, the healer, the rescuer. We mentioned all that in the first card. In the art of living, we sometimes overlook an important skill. Receiving gracefully and with gratitude without diminishing yourself or trying to deny vulnerability or bringing an agenda of equality to it. Sometimes you gotta reach out for help and be vulnerable. Sometimes it comes and more times it doesn't. Receiving is hard for some people, maybe you. You do not need a this for that in your exchange with others. You are doing good in the world. Let the world give back and support you. Then you can give up the old stories that have you convinced you have to do everything alone with no help. Let your well be filled. And that came up for me during the week too, and I was mirroring somebody else. I reached out, I didn't get an answer, I didn't get help, I didn't get a hug. And it was later I realized that I was mirroring that person too. That they, at some stage, had reached out and didn't get help. And then they started going it alone. And then, looking back, starting my healing path, I did go it alone too. But I did reach out for help. I did go to groups. I did go to healers. You know, so I wasn't. But sometimes you do feel you're going it alone. But we're not. Okay? So let go of the feeling that you have to do everything alone with no help. Let your well be filled. We all love you so, so much. Lovely deck there. So I'll leave it at that. We're on 1622, so I will leave you with love and light. I leave all my links below, and I'm available for readings or anything in person or phone or whatever you need. And my Patreon page and Gumroad as well, to see what I have to offer there. So love and light to you, and we'll talk to you next week, please God.